Good morning. This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us now for a look back at this week aboard the International Space Station. The six crew members aboard the station include Russian cosmonaut and commander of the complex Gennady Padalka and flight engineers cosmonaut Sergei Revin, NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, and now cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide. The newest crew members of Expedition 32, Malenchenko, Williams, and Hoshide, arrived at the International Space Station aboard their Soyuz TMA-05M and docked to the Rosviet module of the space station at 11:51 p.m. late Monday night. Then the hatches opened early Tuesday morning at 2:23 Central Time. The new trio will close their first week in space today, and meanwhile aboard the station to greet their new crew members, Padalka, Revin, and Acaba will be completing their 68th consecutive day in space. And now let's look back at this week aboard the International Space Station. On Monday, the station crew had a shorter day with a sleep period 6 hours earlier than normal to accommodate the arrival of the three new crewmates. Before their early sleep period, the station crew members had worked with a variety of ongoing science and maintenance activities. Revin had worked with the radiation payload suite, Matryoshka, which is designed for sophisticated radiation studies and is named after the traditional Russian set of nested dolls. Then Commander Padalka worked in the Russian segment of the station, monitoring its systems and performing preventative maintenance on the ventilation system. While Acaba performed some training with the robotics onboard trainer. This is to prepare for the rendezvous and capture of the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency's third H-2 transfer vehicle that is set to launch to the station tonight at 9:06 p.m. Central Time. Acaba also performed some maintenance on the Express Rack 5 utility drawer lid hatches. Three new Expedition 32 crew members docked to the Rosviet module of the International Space Station late that night at 11:52 p.m. Central Time. Then flight engineers Sunny Williams, Yuri Malenchenko, and Aki Hoshide launched aboard their Soyuz TMA-05M, their spacecraft, at 9:40 p.m. Saturday from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. Again, they arrived to dock to the Rosviet module of the International Space Station at 11:51 p.m. Central Time. Then on Tuesday, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams and Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide joined their Expedition 32 crewmates as their new flight engineers when the hatches between their Soyuz spacecraft and the International Space Station officially opened at 2:23 a.m. Central Time Tuesday. Commander Gennady Padalka and flight engineer Sergei Revin and flight engineer Joe Acaba welcomed their new crew members aboard the orbital home for the next 4 months. After participating in a welcoming ceremony with family and mission officials at the Mission Control Center in Star City, Russia, the newly expanded crew quickly went to work. Padalka and Revin had conducted a session with the bar experiment, which looks at methods and instruments for detecting the location of a loss of pressure aboard the station. Acaba then swapped out and recharged a battery associated with the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which measures the atrophy of the heart muscle that appears to develop during long-duration spaceflight. He also performed some maintenance on the -80-degree laboratory freezer. Then Williams, Hoshide, and Malenchenko unloaded items from their Soyuz spacecraft as well as outfitted their new crew quarters. And then all six crew members then participated in a safety briefing to review their roles and responsibility and the event of an emergency. Then on Wednesday, new flight engineer Aki Hoshide spent some time reviewing the station's exercise equipment. However, most of his day was spent on the robotics training for the arrival of Japan's HTV cargo vehicle known as Kunitori 3. Flight engineer Joe Acaba joined Hoshide in the robotics training. The Kunitori 3 again is scheduled to arrive at the station on July 27 when it will be grappled with the Canada Arm 2 and berthed to the Harmony node. Akaba also powered up the ham radios in the Columbus laboratory and the Zvezda service module. He demonstrated the treadmill operations to HOSHIDE and flight engineer Sunny Williams, who were new to the International Space Station. And Williams had worked on two ongoing science experiments for the InSpace 3 experiment. Wednesday's objective was to restore an even distribution of particles inside a fluid. Benefits include the production of smarter and stronger materials. She also reviewed operations for the BAS experiment, or burning and suppressions of solids. Then flight engineer Sergey Revin on Wednesday studied potential ways to detect a pressure loss in the station for the bar experiment. And Commander Gennady Padalka concentrated on maintenance inside the station's Russian segment. Flight engineer Yuri Malenchenko performed maintenance as well, transferred gear from the Soyuz TMA-05M, and also conducted crew orientation activities. Then on Thursday, flight engineers Sunny Williams, Yuri Malenchenko, and Aki Hoshide joined Commander Gennady Padalka and flight engineer Sergey Revin and Joe Akaba for a review of crew emergency roles and responsibilities. Akaba and Hoshide then performed some training again with the robotics onboard trainer to prepare for the rendezvous and capture of the Japanese HTV cargo vehicle, the Kunitori 3, that is set to launch to the station tonight again at 9.06 p.m. Central Time. The rendezvous, capture, and berthing of the cargo vehicle are scheduled for July 27th. Then to prepare the Space Station Progress 47 cargo vehicle for its undocking, Padalka and Malenchenko installed a docking mechanism and also ran some tests with Toru, the Russian telerobotically operated rendezvous system. Williams worked with the burning and suppression of solids BAS experiment. That experiment examines the burning and extension characteristics of a wide variety of fuel samples in the microgravity. And Sergey Revin worked with the typology experiment, which studies changes in a cosmonaut's reaction time during the long-duration spaceflight. Meanwhile, on Thursday, Hoshide participated in an in-flight educational event for the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. He spoke with students in Tanegashima and also Scuba Japan. And today, Friday, July 20th, Commander Padalka continues final preparations for this weekend's departure of the Progress 47. This is the Russian cargo ship for its undocking this weekend. The Progress 47 vehicle is set to undock from the Piers docking compartment Sunday at 3:27 p.m. Central Time. The cargo ship will back away from the station and then redock on Monday night. The vehicle's undock and redock exercise is to test a new Kurs docking system. We'll have live coverage of the initial undocking on Sunday afternoon at 3 p.m. Central Time here on NASA television. Meanwhile, flight engineer Joe Akaba removed and replaced the water recovery system's recycle filter tank assembly for urine processing of the onboard water recovery system that converts urine, sweat, and condensation into drinkable water. And Akaba then conducted a fitness evaluation and a periodic health checkup with some help from his crewmate, flight engineer Sunny Williams. Akaba then assisted Williams with an integrated cardiovascular ambulatory monitoring system that studies the atrophy of the heart muscle during long-duration spaceflight. Also today, Akaba, Williams, and Hoshide worked together in more onboard training using the station robotics to practice vehicle rendezvous and capture in advance of the arrival of the third Japanese cargo supply ship, H2 transfer vehicle, or the Kunitori 3. Akaba also will prepare the Node 2 Nadir hatch for the arrival of the vehicle. The cargo ship is scheduled to launch from the Tanegashima Space Center in Japan tonight at 9.06 p.m. Central Time. We'll have live coverage of the cargo ship's launch here on NASA television beginning at 8.15 p.m. Central Time, 9.15 p.m. Eastern Time. And also today, flight engineer Sunny Williams performed the reversible figures experiment. She also will spend time on an entry as part of the journal study and participate in a private medical conference. Meanwhile, today, Hoshide reviewed procedures for the minus 80 degree laboratory freezer, and then also removed and restowed the current list contents of the lab aft stowage location and moved some space hardware to that location. The newest crew members aboard the International Space Station will also have more time today for additional adaptation and familiarization. The crew is scheduled to go to bed at 5:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.